Everyone, welcome to our video class section. Today we are discussing the NEET questions from the chapter Principles of Inheritance and Variation. The first question is conditions of a karyotype 2n minus 1 or plus 1, 2n plus 1 or minus 2 are called. So what does karyotype means? Karyotype means the arrangement of chromosomes. The arrangement of chromosome is known as karyotype. So here 2n plus 1 or 2n minus 2 condition. Okay, so the condition is known as aneuploidy. Aneuploidy is a condition that arises due to abnormal number of chromosomes in the zygote. It is of two types, either hyperploidy and hyperploidy. Hyperploidy means addition of chromosome. For example, trisomy, tetrasomy, like that. Okay, then hyperploidy means loss of the chromosome. Okay, so 2n minus 2 nullisomic and 2n minus 1 monosomic condition. Clear it is. Next question is hemophilia disease in man is linked with. So hemophilia disease in man is linked with, the options are autosomes, Y chromosome, chromosome number 21 and X chromosome. So we know the fact that hemophilia is a sex linked recessive disease. So the chromosome location for the disease is X chromosome. Next question is arrangement of sex chromosome in Klinefelter syndrome is. So in case of Klinefelter syndrome, the total number of chromosome is 47. That means 46 plus an additional X chromosome will be there. Okay, so the arrangement of sex chromosome in Klinefelter syndrome is XXY. Next question, sickle cell anemia, a hereditary disease, was first described by. Sickle cell anemia, a hereditary disease, was first described by. The options are James B. Herrick, William Harvey, Carl Leinster, J. Priestley. Okay, so James Brian Herrick, an American physician, is credited with the description of a disease, sickle cell anemia. Okay, we know that sickle cell anemia is an autosomal hereditary disorder, and one of the first physicians to describe the symptoms of myocardial infarction was also James Brian Herrick. Okay, so the next question is, person suffering from sickle cell anemia normally do not suffer from. Options are cholera, malaria, high blood pressure, hepatitis. So the sickle cell anemic patients are able to withstand the disease malaria, because malarial parasites are unable to penetrate the erythrocyte membrane and cause any harm, because the erythrocyte is get changed into sickle shape. Okay, so there occur always occur change in the structure of the protein, so the malarial parasite doesn't penetrate the erythrocyte membrane and cause any harm. Next question is, a man whose father was a colorblind marries a woman who had colorblind mother and normal father. What percentage of male children of this couple will be colorblind? Okay, so the case is that a man whose father was colorblind, and marries a woman who had a colorblind mother and a normal father. Okay, so in her body also the defective gene is present. So what is the percentage of male children of this couple will be colorblind? So the so it is clear that 50% of chance for getting the colorblind child. Next question is, a human female with Turner syndrome. Okay, so the Turner syndrome's condition is 45 chromosomes with XO. Next question, which of the following occurs due to monosomy of sex chromosome? Monosomy of sex chromosome. Okay, so Down syndrome. Options are Down syndrome, Turner syndrome, hemophilia and sickle cell anemia. So thus Down syndrome and Turner syndromes are occurred due to aneuploidy. Okay, so Down syndrome is an example for the triploid condition and Turner syndrome is example for a monosomic condition. So the correct answer is Turner syndrome. Okay, lessen the suffering of phenylketonurias, their diet should have no phenylalanine and tyrosine, no phenylalanine and normal requirement of tyrosine, normal recommended amount of phenylalanine, normal recommended amount of both phenylalanine and tyrosine. Okay, so in case of PKU patients, what will happen? The options were given. So in order to lessening the suffering of phenylketonuria, their diet should have low phenylalanine and normal requirement of tyrosine, because on the PKU patients, the phenylalanine not get converted into tyrosine. Okay, but our body required tyrosine for the metabolism of for the production of dopamine and melatonin. Clear it is. So option B is the right one.